Fukushima Fallout Awareness Network. First there was Three Mile Island, then Chernobyl, and now Fukushima. Now April 10th is BAD, B-A-D, Becquerel Awareness Day, because rats are bad to eat. We need you to call your representatives on Thursday, April 10th, to demand that the FDA do their job in creating transparent and responsible binding limits for radiation in our food. Kids are depending on us. You can RSVP for the event and invite others to join on the Facebook event page that was created. And then also you can get more information on talking points, updates, links on the homepage for the group. There is a video here that you can watch that goes into great detail about what this is all about. Now, we know that not everybody is on Facebook, so all of the links that are on Facebook are in this website. You can go into the Take Action page, the Seafood page. You can go into the media so that you can learn more. So let's go back to the Facebook. Call into action, Becquerel Awareness Day, 4/10/14. First there was Three Mile Island, Chernobyl, then Fukushima. Now April 10th is Becquerel Awareness Day. It's bad because rads are bad to eat. This is will literally take you 5 minutes. That's all we're asking for, is 5 minutes to make a phone call and talk to your elected officials, your senators, your representatives. If you can't talk to them, you can leave a message. We're going to demand that they lower their outrageous, the FDA lowered their outrageous regulations for radiation in our food, which is currently the highest in the world. So, there are all kinds of links here. Everyone who has liked this page, please RSVP on the event page to ensure that this Thursday is a big success. So the FDA, slow to respond to the Fukushima radiation call to action. Let's take a look at that. Blogs.naturalnews.com, FDA, slow to respond to Fukushima radiation, call to action on 4/10. Written by Kimberly Roberson of Fukushima Fallout Awareness Network. FFAN is urging the public to participate in a national call-in to action day this coming Thursday, April 10th, by contacting their elected representatives who work for us in demanding a rational, transparent, and binding level for testing radiation in food. This is in response to very recent statements by the Food and Drug Administration that it sees no reason to alter consumption of specific foods imported from Japan or domestically produced food, including seafood. All that's needed on April 10th is a phone to let DC know we're demanding that the FDA act responsibly in the ongoing wake of Fukushima. So this is in response to FDA's actions as outlined in this press release, Washington, April 3, 2014. The Fukushima Fallout Awareness Network responded to statements by the Food and Drug Administration that the agency is not advising people to alter their consumption of specific foods imported from Japan or domestically produced food, including seafood, in the wake of the ongoing radioactive releases at Japan's Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power station. The National Academy of Sciences has stated that there is no safe dose of radiation. Therefore, FFAN rejects the current high levels that the FDA recommends for food. FFAN Coalition member groups Beyond Nuclear, Citizens for Health, and Ecological Options Network filed a legal citizen petition with the FDA on March 12th of 2013 to lower the amount of radioactive cesium allowed in the food. The FDA's only direct response to FFAN citizen petition is a letter dated June of 2013 stating they require more time to respond. The American Medical Association, or the AMA resolution, has called on the U.S. government to test all U.S. seafood for radiation due to Fukushima and fully report the results to the public. In addition, scientists from Bedford Institute of Oceanography have found levels of cesium in seawater off the Vancouver, Canada coast that can be attributed to the Fukushima nuclear disaster. The levels are currently low, but the presence of cesium-134 confirms the contamination to be from Fukushima Daiichi. So if the FDA wants to claim seafood is safe, then they need to institute a more robust food testing process. Considering the continued dumping of Fukushima radiation into the Pacific, we need to constantly monitor our seafood because the contamination levels we see today could certainly change. This catastrophe and its impact on seafood will not be over for a very long time, stated Cindy Folkers of Beyond Nuclear. 3 years after the nuclear disaster began in Japan on the shores of the Pacific Ocean, and the FDA has not authorized a rational, transparent, and binding limit for radiation in food. Instead, they recommend at minimum 1,200 becquerels per kilogram of cesium-134 and 137. This is the highest allowable levels for radiation in food in the world. The FDA's limit is 12 times higher than Japan's, meaning that in addition to seafood, other foods and beverages considered far too dangerous for consumption there can be exported to U.S. citizens, including vulnerable children and pregnant women. FFAN's petition seeks to significantly lower the current allowable levels of radiation in all food, including seafood, to 5 becquerels per kilogram, which is nearly identical to the limits proposed by the International Physicians for the Prevention of Nuclear War, the IPPNW, which is in Germany and the EU. So, why does the FDA think it's okay to expose kids in the U.S. to 12 times more radioactive poison than children in Japan? Even Japan's limits are not protective enough. If this is the standard the FDA uses to determine what is safe, then our children are in danger, stated Folkers, adding without a responsible contamination limit set, the FDA will doom a certain number of people to unnecessary disease, particularly children who are much more vulnerable to radiation. The AMA joins FFAN in demanding the public's right to know regarding radiation levels in food. Both want a national database and transparent seafood testing, and FFAN invites others, you, me, and anybody else you know, to join in demanding that the FDA reduce the amount of radiation permitted in our food in a transparent and responsible manner. So, let's see, great links here. So, I'm going to show you where you can go to contact the elected officials to make your 5-minute phone call. Promise, 5 minutes. But I just wanted to scroll down here and show you a little bit more because there is an awful lot of information here that you can use as a script or as points, bullet points, so that you can talk to your elected officials and possibly even educate them. So here is a sample language. This letter is on the Fukushima Fallout Awareness Network website as well. There are facts and figures here. It's very, very easy. This is very easy to use. So here is the link for the contact elected officials. This is also on FFAN's website. USA.gov. Here's the U.S. senators. And you just go up in here and you put your state in, and phone numbers will come up. The names of who your senators are. Then we have the U.S. representatives. And if you don't know who your representatives are for your state, you just come up here and put in your zip code, and your state will come up with who the people are based on your zip code. And again, here's a phone number. So, please put this on your calendar. Tell your representatives on April 10th that the FDA must act responsibly. 5 minutes of time might make all the difference in the world. Because if we don't come together, they're just going to continue on. And small actions times lots of people equals big change. Let's be the change. Thank you so much for participating. And you can come back in here. You can go to the event page. This is where you can invite friends. You can confirm that you are going to be involved in this, that you will be going to the event. You'll be okay. So thank you very much for your time. And we look forward to your comments on the event page. Thank you.